Okay, guys, I'm putting this warning at the beginning of this video, and this is one of the only videos I ever put a warning at the beginning of, simply because I'm doing some quick draws in this video from different positions, from a seated position and from a standing position. But basically, this video is some tips over the years that just through my experience from carrying a weapon for 35 years, and for fat guys or girls or fat people in general, how to carry a weapon comfortably and safely, and how to draw fast with it from the seated position and standing position. Now look, in the video, I took the magazine out for the first couple of shots, but you don't get the feel of the real draw of a fully loaded magazine with the mag out. It just don't feel right. It's top heavy. You see what I'm saying? So I put the magazine back in halfway through this video, but I did not load around the chamber. So do not attempt quick draw practices of any sort, even drawing, not even quick, with a loaded round in the chamber. Do not do it. It's not safe. You can shoot yourself, you can shoot somebody. You know, accidents do happen. But I put a fully loaded magazine and I didn't load around in the chamber. So the chamber was empty during this whole video. All right, guys, that being said, be careful, be safe, and maybe this will help some people out, maybe it won't. And if you're not a fat person, even it still may help you, you know. It's just different ideals, more than one way to skin a cat, man. And when you're in a vehicle wearing a seatbelt, even for thin people, it's kind of hard sometimes to draw your weapon out with a seatbelt on, depending on where you have your weapon. So this here is an alternative to a holster while wearing a seatbelt. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Enjoy it. Hello, YouTube. Hotly Retired here. All right, guys, today I'm going to be talking about some tips for fat people carrying concealed, or fat guys concealed weapon carrying tips. But the biggest one I found, the most comfortable, and this is, all right, guys, this here is a concealed weapons position, I guess is what you could say, for carrying a weapon in a vehicle. And most fat people, if they have their gun on their side and they're sitting in the vehicle and you got the console right there, like on my truck, I got a fold down console in the middle between the seats. It's got cup holders and all kinds of stuff in it. And also you can lift it up and it makes a spare seat up front. But anyway, it's just would be hard to get to, you know, get to your weapon when you're hemmed up in between that console and the car door and all this stuff, especially if you're a wide body. So the best way, the best thing I ever come up with is carrying right here in the shirt pocket, and it's easy to get to. And this is a 9mm. And yeah, I'm gonna put that back in. I don't have around, well, I'll take it out. For the video. All right, I got a tetanus clip on here, guys. Sometimes I just carry this gun in my front pocket without a jacket on, or with a jacket. I mean, it fits comfortable. So, and when you're sitting in a vehicle, it's just, I mean, it's handy right here. It's right here on the driver's side, right here. Now, I realize you can't carry a heavy weapon in your shirt pocket because it does drag it down a little bit, but not that bad. Not bad at all, really. But as far as getting to it quickly and the ease and the comfort of carry, I could be driving and not even know this is right here. So when I'm driving, That's how I wear it. Just right here in my pocket. It's not really concealed. And it's not really in plain sight. So, and you're in the vehicle anyway. Just quick motion, man. It's quick motion. Quick. Another way I wear this, sometimes I wore it around my neck, under my shirt, with a necklace made, like a cord, and hook it to a Technoclip. I might pause it and see if I can find that cord. All right, guys, another way that I have carried it, but not very much, is around my neck on a chain. And it comes right off. Technoclip, buddy, Technoclip. The places to conceal with a Technoclip are limitless, guys. Limitless. And it don't look, I mean, it sticks out a little bit. But I usually wear a t-shirt under a shirt when I carry like this. Usually I don't even carry like this. That's just another option. My number one concern when I carry is comfort. That's number one. Because if it ain't comfortable, you're not going to carry it every day. And if you don't carry every day, you're not protected every day. So that's number one in my book. Number two is caliber. When I first started carrying concealed many, many years ago, I was carrying a 32 caliber pistol for comfort, but I had some concerns about whether the round had enough stopping power. So when they come up with the Ruger LC9S, I decided to go 9mm, basically the same size as a 32, the same weight as a 32. Actually, there's some 32s that are a lot heavier and a lot bigger than this. But for that same size as a 32, you get the power of a 9mm. Which I'm not saying, 9mm's a great round, but it's better than a 32 in my opinion. So, and then to make it more flexible in carrying, I added the Technoclip. And the Technoclip, with the Technoclip, you can carry this gun, I'm telling you, anywhere on your person. Anywhere, in your underwear. In your waistband of your underwear. In your pants waistband, in your pocket, shirt pocket, under your shirt, on a necklace. You can buy a side holster if you want it. You can put it, if you got some good socks, you could wear this down in your sock with the Technoclip. And the Technoclip keeps it secure, guys. I mean, I'm not talking about wearing it in your sock and going out and playing a game of basketball or anything like that. But as far as general walking goes, yeah. I mean, you could put this gun anywhere. And the reason I'm oiling this thing up is because, like I said, guys, anytime it makes contact with your skin, I put a little oil on here just to keep it from rusting. You know, because your skin has salt, moisture, water, just all kinds of gunk. All right, put it back in my pocket. Put the clip in. I'm not going to chamber around. Put it right back there in my shirt pocket, guys. And how fast can I draw my pistol from a concealed position? Well, I don't know, but I'm going to try it. Pretty fast. From a concealed position. From the shirt pocket. Sitting in a vehicle. Like driving around. And here. a good one. Now I'm gonna do the same thing for my shirt pocket. This has a mag in it, and the mag is loaded, but there's not one in the chamber. I wanted to do that so I could get the weight of drawing a full magazine. All right, this would be like if I'm driving down the road or I'm setting my truck. Okay. I actually think I can draw faster in the seated position, which I'm gonna try that. Right, here I am driving down, park. Sitting in my truck. Bad guy coming at me. Even with the seatbelt on, guys, and I do have a little hole in my pocket where I carry it so much it put a hole in my shirt pocket at the bottom. But anyway, even with the seatbelt going across here, guys, actually the seatbelt makes it even better. It holds everything, my shirt tight, holds everything just tight. So actually I can draw quicker wearing a seatbelt, because when I pull this gun up, this pocket stays down. It's basically like, so I got my hand, this is my seatbelt. I mean, it's quick, guys, quick. See a threat? See a threat? All right. Threat. Threat. Yeah. Even if I got it in my pocket, I could still draw it quick. But the thing about it is, I'm a wide body. I'm a fat boy. And I'm sitting in my truck, and I got a console right here beside of me. I'm pretty much, there's not a lot of space between me, my gun, and my center console. And there's not a lot of space between me and the door. And guys, if you're a left-handed fat boy, if you buy a woman's t-shirt, the pocket's on the other side, so you can draw from this way. But you could probably still, you know, it's just more comfortable. But anyway, drawing from the hip, with the technically, it's pretty easy because I don't have that console here. Let me try it one more time. This would be good like if I'm sitting at a restaurant though. Sitting at a restaurant eating, all of a sudden comes a threat.